Hello, hello guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. I hope you guys are doing good. As for me, I am doing fantastic. Those who are joining us for the first time, guys, feel welcome. And those who are always joining me, guys, thank you very much. I appreciate you. All my subscribers, I appreciate you. My name is Nati, and after watching this video, please don't forget to like, to subscribe and share. So guys, today we're just going to do computer practice and 4XL 2022. I've already done the theory part, so let's do Excel. My info, please sit in front. Let's do this. So like I always advise, please do read the instructions. It's very important. And those small changes that they ask you to do, like changing your page orientation, please do that before you can do all the calculations. Saving the question paper, please do. I mean your answer sheet, please do that before you can answer, before you can start with the calculations. And also computer practice, it's all about formulas, so make sure that you know your formulas very well. Okay, so let's start. Our first question is increased numbers. We must find the increased numbers. Number of users minus number of users 2019, which means is 2019 minus 2018. And they say display the answer as a number with one decimal. I've already keyed in. So what you do, you come here, you say equals to, then you drag it down, minus. Then this one, you drag it down, then equals to. That's your answer, and mine is already on one decimal. If you don't know how to do a one decimal, you just click here, right click, then you go to format cells. Then you see, you come to numbers, decimal, one decimal, or you can change it to two decimal if they have told you you have to change it to two decimal. So you just press OK. Since I highlighted this thing, all the columns, when doing the first one, I don't have to do the second one, you know. I just have to drag it down, because already by just highlighting those ones, it gives me answers for the rest. So the second question says total percentage of total users 2019, which means you are going to divide 2019 by the total of number of users 2019. So for us to calculate the percentage, which means we have to calculate the total first, use the absolute cell reference, cell addresses I meant, which is the dollar sign, and display the number as a percentage with one decimal. So you just come here, equals to, then you go to your formulas, then auto sum, that's where you find your sum there. Then you highlight here, up to here, enter. You come here, equals to your auto sum, that's where there's your sum there. You highlight, enter. You come here, equals to auto sum, then you highlight here. Then that's your answer there. Let me just close this one, a border, it's a bottom border. Then equals to, we're calculating this one, 2019. What you do is you highlight everything here, then divide. Remember, they say you must use a total of users in 2019, which is 34, and you must use the cell, the absolute cell address. You come here, you do like this, then here on alphabetical, remember C it's a column and 14 it's a row, which means in front of C you put your dollar sign. The back of C, you put your dollar sign also. the dollar sign, then enter. Already it's like this. Remember, it must be on one decimal. Mine is already on one decimal. Then you drag it down. It's like this. Then the third question says, total of each column by using a function, display the answers as integers, which means they must have no decimal. Your numbers must have no what? No decimal. Excuse me. They must have no what? No decimal, like this, since they don't have decimal. So let's do the total one. Equals to, then your formula, then do like this, you highlight, then like this. Then here it is. It's what? It's no decimal. It's no decimal. So we come to average users, which means you must find the average users in number in 2018. What you do, you go to your formula, you say equals to, let me remove this D. I put this D so that I don't confuse myself. Then you go to formulas, then you come here, you look for average. This is your average. Then you click your average there. You click your average there. Then you come here, you highlight up until here, then you enter. Also here you're looking for average, you say equals to average, come here, then enter. Here on F you are looking for minimum increase equals to auto sum. You come to your mean, minimum, go like this, then you enter. That's your answers day. That's your answers day. Average using function, the answer as an integer. All of them display on the minimum with one decimal. With what? With one decimal. Coming here, the total in the last column, percentage of total users, must be displayed with no decimal. You see, I told you, you must every time read instruction, do everything accordingly. If you have to change something, which is the last question, go back and change it. So which means here it must be one decimal. It must be one decimal, which means you come here and check on your what is a one decimal. Okay. Here it must be an integer, which means it does not have to have a decimal, which means it's zero here. It will be 8. And also here. Number, it will also be what? Be 8. So here it is. And then here they say it must not have a decimal, which means you just highlight, come here, format cell, no decimal. See, it's supposed to be like this. Let's check our 100%. Also, you see, no decimal. Then, okay. The total must display as no decimal, which we did. Display by as a one decimal, which we did, and this one, which we did. So that's your N4 2022 Excel. If you have any questions, please don't be afraid to ask.